Hi guys, welcome again to Sunil Engineering Academy YouTube channel. And this is Srinivas, aptitude trainer. Please subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications. In our channel, we have been running a special quantitative aptitude series. In that series, we have already covered ratio and proportion and partnership. Both the chapters have been completed. And now we are moving to the most important topic on the entire quantitative aptitude. That is nothing but percentage. Percentage is the most important topic in the quantitative aptitude. Major part of the quantitative aptitude is entirely depend on percentage. If we take the exciting chapters of profit loss, if we take the simple interest, if we take the compound interest, not only the main chapters, the most important data interpretation and some portions of the mensuration also runs with percentage only, and allegation mixtures, and all these major parts of the quantitative aptitude runs on the concept of percentage only. We can say that over 60% of the question paper, over 60% of the quantitative aptitude section in any examination is runs on percentage and its relative topics only. So be careful while learning percentage. I am going to give you the full concept of percentage and plenty of questions and the previous questions, and I am not going to spare any inch of the concept of percentage related to the competitive examinations. Okay, so first of all, what is percentage? The percentage name itself suggests the meaning of percentage. Per, that means for. Cent means 100. Cent means 100. That means whichever value we take it, that is when compared to 100, the value of anything we can take, that is comparable with the 100. That means cent means 100. Percent is nothing but a form of ratio. In the ratio and proportion chapter, we came to know that A is to B is a ratio, and A and B are two independent terms, and there is a ratio. That means the comparison between them, the comparison between two similar things is nothing but ratio. In the ratio, there can be two different independent terms, but when the second term or the antecedent of the ratio is fixed as 100, when the second term or antecedent, that is the B term, is fixed as 100, that is nothing but percentage. When you fix the antecedent of a ratio as 100, that is nothing but percentage. Comparing any value with 100 is nothing but percentage. The ratio A is to B can be written as A upon B. In the same way, the ratio A is to 100 can be written as A upon 100. This A upon 100 is nothing but percentage. The meaning percentage means comparing any value with 100. Comparing any value with 100. That is nothing but percentage. And we denote percentage with this sign. We all know that percentage is denoted by this sign. If we write that sign beside any value, let us say write that sign of percentage beside A. Now this is read as a percentage. If you put that sign beside 3, it is read as 3%. If you put that percentage sign beside something, any ratio, 2 by 3%, this 2 by 3 and beside this sign is read as 2 by 3%. Okay. We can now say that percentage is nothing but comparing any value with 100. That means the antecedent of a ratio is fixed as 100. Okay. The first point of percentage, what we need to know is how to write the structure of percentage in a mathematical way. The mathematical notation of percentage. Okay. Just write as we read. We don't need to bother about the structure, the mathematical notation of percentages. The mathematical notation of percentage is nothing but what we just read. What we just read. Let us say, this is read as 3%. 3%. The mathematical notation of 3% would be just write what we read. What we read. Just read this sentence, that is 3%. 3. First of all, we are reading 3. Just write 3. Then we are reading per. Per means by. Per means by. Cent. Cent means 100. Cent means 100. So, to write the mathematical notation of 3%, just write 3 upon 100. This is the mathematical representation of 3%. We don't need to bother about the structures. Just read. Just write what we read. If you take 23%, how we read this 23%? First of all, we are reading 23. Just write 23. Then we are reading per. Just give that per sign. That means the upon sign. Cent. That means 100. So, to write the mathematical notation or to get the mathematical notation of 23%, just write as we read. Okay. First point. And then, next point. Some mathematical notations or some mathematical expressions of percentage. Some mathematical expressions of percentage. If you write a percentage, we just knew that a percentage, you can write that a percentage as a by 100, a upon 100. Okay. Then what about the fractions? Before going to fraction to integer percentage or percent to fraction conversion, let me introduce you some very good concepts of percentage. That is first point. Any value when compared with 100, any value when compared with 100 gives the percentage value as itself. That means if we compare 3 with 100, that is nothing but 3%. If we compare 12.5 with 100, that is nothing but 12.5%. Any value when compared with 100 gives the percentage value itself. This is the most important and the key point of percentage concept. And another point. Any value is 100% when compared with itself. If we compare any value with the same number, it is 100%. If we compare 3 with 3, this is 100%. If we compare 17 with 17, that is 100%. Any value is 100% with respect to this itself, These are two very key points we are going to utilize in the concept of percentage. Next concept. How to know the percentage value. Okay. Just take a single line that 2 is what percent of 2 is what percent of 50? Okay. We need to find the percentage of 2 out of 50. Now, the mathematical representation would be as like this. We need to find the percentage of 2. The percentage value of 2. Just write the 2 in the numerator. and we need to take the percentage value of 2 out of 50, out of 50. So write that 50 in the denominator, write that 50 in denominator. To get the percentage, just multiply that fraction with 100, just multiply that fraction with 100. Okay, now we get, now we are able to get the percentage of 2 out of 50. That is nothing but 51, 52, that is 4%. Now we can say that 2 is 4% of 50. 2 is 4% of 50. 2 is 4% of 50. This is the very preliminary, this is a very preliminary concept which is used in the percentage to find the required percent out of the given number. Okay, first of all converting fraction into percentage, if you have a fraction a by b, if you have a fraction a upon b, we need to convert that into percentage. Just multiply that fraction with 100. Now we are with the percentage value of the fraction a upon b. When we simplify the ratio, then we can get the percentage value of a upon b. In the same way, if we need to write the percentage value of a fraction 4 upon 5, to get the percentage value of a fraction 4 upon 5, just multiply that fraction with 100. 5 ones and 5 20s, that is 80%. This is the simple method to convert fractions into percentages. Just multiply that fraction with 100 to convert any fraction into percentage. If you have a fraction c by d, to convert that into percentage, just multiply that c by d with 100. If you have a fraction 2 by 20 or 1 by 10, let's take it 1 by 10. This is a fraction and we need to convert this fraction into percentage. Just multiply that fraction with 100. We are going to get the percentage value, that is percentage. Okay. The conversion of fraction to percentage is okay. Then what about the conversion of percentage to fraction? Conversion of percentage to fraction. Percentage to fraction. Let us take the value 5%. 5%. This is read as 5%. Just take the notation of mathematical notation of 5% as we read it. As I already told you, write that mathematical notation as we read, as we read it. 5%. Write that 5% means 100. That gives us 1 upon 20. 1 upon 20 is the fraction value of 5%. Conversion of percentage to fraction. To convert percentage into fraction, just divide that value with 100. When you need to convert the value of 14% to fraction, just divide that 14 with 100. Then you are going to get 7 upon 50. That 7 upon 50 is the fraction value of the percentage of 14%. Okay, 14%. But just take care while converting the percentage into fraction, and the percentage in the form of fraction. When you take 2 by 3%, as I already told you, just write as we read. 2 upon 3, per mean by, cent, that means 100, Now, you are going to get 2 upon 300, this 100 is going to be multiple with 3, that means 2 upon 300. To convert the fractional percentage into fraction, just divide that fraction with 100, If you need to convert 7 by 2 percentage into fraction, just divide that 7 by 2 with 100, then you are going to get 7 upon 200. These are the very key points in percentage. Very key point in percentage. Let me summarize you. Percentage to fraction. Percentage to fraction. And then fraction to percentage. Fraction to percentage. Percentage to fraction. If you have something percentage, if you have something percentage, that means a percentage. To convert into fraction, just divide that numerical value with 100. Or just write as you read. We read it as a percent, that means 100. Or you can divide that a with 100. That means to convert percentage into fraction, divide by 100 or divide with 100. Okay? Divide with 100. If you have x percentage, to convert that x percentage into fraction, just divide that x by 100. If you have a by b percentage, this is not a fraction. That a by b is in the form of percentage. Just you need to divide that a by b 100. That means a upon 100b would be the value when converted from percentage to fraction. Or if you need to convert fraction to percentage, that means a upon b is a fraction. To convert that a upon b into percentage, just multiply that a upon b with 100. To convert percentage into fraction, divide with 100. And to convert fraction to percentage, multiply with 100. If you have a fractional value 2 by 3, the percentage value of 2 upon 3 would be 200 by 3. Why 200 by 3? Since 2 upon 3 is multiple with 100, to get into the percentage value, the percentage value would be 2 upon 3 percentage. If you need to convert 3 upon 20 into percentage value, just multiple that 3 upon 20 with 100, then you get the percentage value of 21s and 25s, that is 15%. That 15% would be the percentage value of the given fraction 3 upon 20. These are very key points in percentage. Take a note of these one. And if you talk about taking of the required percentage out of the given number, if you need to find out 15% of 200, then how to find? We need 15%. Just write that 15 in the numerator, and 15% can be represented as 15 upon 100. Just write as you read. This is read as 15% of 200. This can be read as 15% of 200. So write as you read. 15% half means a multiple sign of 200. If you need to get the required percentage out of the given number, just write as you read it. This can be read as 15% of 200. We have written just as we read 15% of 200. Just simplify that value. 100 ones and 102, that is 30%. Okay. In the same way, to calculate any required percentage, just write as you read it. If you need to take 20% of 300, then the structure would be 20% of means multiple sign 300 of 300. 100 ones and 100 threes, that is 60%. Okay, we don't have a problem here. Don't skip the video. In percentage concept, every key point is very essential to solve some incredible questions. And I have already told you that percentage is going to be used in very, very much in multiple concepts. Okay. Just how to find some standard percentage of the given values. Some standard percentage of the given values. I have already told you, any value or any number is 100% of itself. 100% of itself. Any value is of 100% of itself. Okay, we don't have a problem there. Now we need to find. If you take the 100%, 10%, or 1%. 2% and 3% and so on, etc. We don't need to write the structure again and again to get those required percentage values. Just notice one thing here. To get the 100% of 25, that means I have already told you the point is here. Any value is 100% of itself. That means 100% of 25 would be 25 itself. 100% of 33 would be 33 itself. Any value is 100% when it is compared with itself. Okay, we don't have a problem there. If you need to take the 10% of any value, 10% of something 700. If you need to take 10% of 700, it is very easy to take 10% of any value. We don't need to go through the structural representation of this equation. That is, 10% of is multiple sign 700. 101 and 107, that is 70. Just observe one thing here. To get the 10% of the 10% of the any required any value, just put a decimal mark after one position from the right side of the given value. To get this 10% of the given value 700, put a decimal mark after one place from the right side. That means 70.0. Now that integer part is the required 10% of the given value 700. In the same way, to get the 10% of 235, we don't need to write 10 upon 100 into 235 and all those things. Just to put a decimal place from the right end of the given value, that 23.5, that 23.5 would be the percentage of given value 235. In the same way, we can take the required 10% out of any given value. If you need to take the 10% of 1027, just put a decimal place after one position from the right end of the given number, that is 102.7. 102.7 is the 10% of the given value. Okay. How to find 20%, 30%, 40% and those and so on, or 5% or 5% and all these things. 20%, 30% and 40%, all these things are a multiple of 10 or multiple of 10. If you need to take the 20% of 450, if you need to take the 20% of 450, just to take the 10% of 450. 10% of 450 would be 45.0, that is nothing but 45. Take decimal position after one place from the right end, that is 45.0, that is nothing but 45. When the value of 10% is 45, the value of 20% would be, 20% is 2 times of 10%, then the value of 20% would be 2 times of 45, that is 90. In the same way, we can say that 40% of 450 would be, 40% of 450 would be 4 times of the 10%, 4 times of the 10%, that is 180. Okay. I think now you are very comfortable to take the percentage value of 10, multiples of 10 from the any given value. If you need to take 20% of, if you need to take 20% of 20% of 850, if you need to take 20% of 850, or if you need to take 20% of any number, we can take any another example, just to take the value 20% value of the 850. 10% is 85, then the 20% would be 2 times of the 85, that is 170. That is 170. We need to take 30% of 515. 30% of 515. Then 10% of 515 is 51.5. To get the 30% of the 515, just multiply that 51.5 with 3. 51.5 with 3. That gives us 154.5. Taking off 1% of any value. Taking off 1% of any value. To take 1% of any value, to take 1% of any value, just a mathematical representation would be 1% of any value. Or take an example of 1% of 300. 1% of 300 is the mathematical representation. The simplified value would be 3. Simplified value would be 3. Just observe here once again. To take the 1%, just put a decimal from after 2 place from the right side of the given value. Right side of the given, that is 3.00, that is nothing but 3. So, to get the 1% of the given value, put a decimal place after 2 places from the right end of the given value. That 1% of 999 would be 9.99. Put a decimal place from the right end of the given number after 2 place. 1% of 1350 would be 13.50. 13.50. Put a decimal place after 2 places. If you know the 1% of the given value, we can take 3%, 7%, 9% and so on. Any percentage value of the given number. To take 4% of, to take 4% of 250, to take 4% of 250. When we know the 1% of 250, to get the 4% of 250, we can multiply that 1% with 4. The 1% of 250 is nothing but 2.5. 1% of 250, 1% of 250 is nothing but 2.5. Put a decimal place after two places from the right end of the given value. That is 2.5. When the value of 1% is 2.5, then the value of 4% would be 10. 4% would be 10. Okay. Now we can easily take the required percentage out of the given value. Just to summarize once again. Any value is 100% when compared with itself. The value of the 100% out of 350 is nothing but 350. The 10% of 350 is nothing but 35. When you put a decimal place after one place from the right end, 35. The 1% of 350 would be 3.5. If we are very comfortable with taking these values, then we are not going to employ the mathematical representation in each of the questions to get the required value. We are going to take the required value by looking at itself. Okay. And next one. Having said that any value is of 100% itself, when the value is increased by 20%, take a value of 100. Increase it by 20% increase. 20% of 100 is 10% is 10 and 20% is 20. 20% of 100 is 20. After increasing of 20%, 100 becomes 120. Now we can say that 120 is 120% of 100, 120% of 100. In the same way, any value when increased by X percent, it becomes 100 plus X percent, 100 plus X percent. If you take the value of 200, when it is increased by 30%, when increased by 30%, we can say that the value is nothing but 130% of the original value 200. Original value 200. When you increase a value A by 40%, we can say that value becomes 140% of A. In the same way, when you decrease any value, when you decrease any value by X percent, then it becomes 100 minus X percent of itself. When you decrease a value A by 30%, it becomes 70% of A. It becomes 70% of A. When you decrease a value of X by 35%, it becomes 65% of X. Okay. I hope you are very clear with the two concepts. When you increase a value by X percent, then the value would be 100 plus X percent of the original value. When you decrease a value by X percent, the value becomes 100 minus X percent of the original value. These all are very basic fundamentals of percentage. Very basic fundamentals of percentage. Okay. And to be very comfortable with the coming percentage chapter or profit loss chapter, and then the most important simple interest and compound interest, we should be very able to memorize some fractions and percentage conversions of them, like 1/7, 1/8, 1/16, 1/15, and etc. or 83.33%, or 63.33%, and so on. In my next video, I am going to teach you some standard percentage and fraction values, and application of the percentage and the standard values. So please don't my next video. It is going to be very useful for you in the examinations. Very useful. It will be very useful for you. In the next video, I am going to give you some standard fractions and some standard percentage values of those given fractions and how to utilize them with respect to the given questions in any chapter, no matter whether the chapter is compound interest, simple interest, or profit loss, and it can be any chapter. So our next video is going to be very crucial video in terms of percentage. So just don't miss the next video, and again subscribe this channel and like the video. Please share to your friends and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications. And I am going to give you very good collection of questions from the recent competitive examinations, and some standard questions in the percentage and so on. So please watch every video of mine, and please share to your friends and subscribe this channel. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.